Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and hope you're all having a great time. As usual, we've brought lots of updates about the Starship development and SpaceX in general. At the bustling Starbase facility, the vibrant July 4th celebrations drew to a close on South Padre Island, culminating in a breathtaking fireworks extravaganza that painted the night sky with an array of colors. As the festivities wound down, attention shifted to the ongoing activities at the facility, where a peculiar occurrence caught the eye of onlookers. A PEZ dispenser door had been relocated to the high bay area, prompting speculation about its purpose and whether it was the same door or a modified version with a sturdier frame. According to Elon Musk, the central steel plate for the system is close to being lifted into position. Describing the plate, Musk explains that it consists of two layers of extremely thick and perforated steel, resembling a massive and super strong steel showerhead pointing upwards. The sheer scale and strength of this steel pancake are truly impressive. This crucial component, now known as the central part of the water deluge steel plate system, is being carefully lowered onto the newly prepared concrete surface. While the water deluge system rig has been observed and testing on previous occasions, it remains unclear whether it's been utilized in live missions or if it's still in the development phase. However, significant step forward with the rollout of the central steel plate signifies another milestone in the continuous construction of the OLM water deluge system. The water deluge system is expected to play a crucial role in future missions, ensuring the safety and efficiency of SpaceX's space launches. With each stage of progress, Starbase becomes an even more remarkable hub of innovation and technological achievement. After a swift fit check and even a concrete hardness test, the focus quickly shifted to an intriguing piece of equipment known as the jig. Now positioned directly over the location of the pancake, a water-jacketed structure designed to provide support beneath the rocket and facilitate a regenerative cooling system by circulating water to dampen the exhaust from the 33 engines. The stand responsible for carrying the deluge pancake underneath the OLM orbital launch mount was in motion, gradually making its way towards its intended destination. Amidst the preparations, the two cranes involved in the operation, Grover and Marvin, appeared fully geared up and ready to perform their duties. With everything in place, it was time to lift the deluge pancake onto the nearby movement jig. The careful maneuvering of the pancake onto the jig took a bit of time, as precision was crucial for a secure fit. Once the position was deemed satisfactory, the slings that had facilitated the lift were removed, clearing the way for the jig to be moved beneath the OLM. These slings would be promptly replaced to enable the subsequent lifting and lowering of the pancake into its design location. With the pancake securely placed on the movement jig, the intricate dance continued as it was gradually guided beneath the OLM. After a brief but purposeful period of use, the movement jig was relocated away from the OLM to allow the pancake's precise maneuvering and ultimate placement. As the pancake was gently laid down, signaling a successful operation, the timing couldn't have been more perfect, coinciding with the end of my day and beckoning me to rest. Without delay, the jig and the specialized self-propelled modular transporters, SPMTs, responsible for its movement were swiftly returned to the build site. Excitement grew as BART, the intriguingly named equipment, made a reappearance, indicating a keen interest in testing its compatibility with the newly positioned pancake. According to the unfolding scene, one of the deluge manifolds was set in motion. Meanwhile, the remaining water manifolds, an essential component of the cooling system, are currently being prepared for transport. Their arrival and subsequent integration will continue to the overall functionality and efficiency of the cooling mechanism. These manifolds play a crucial role in fueling and propellant systems of the rockets. The next step in the process involves placing the six outer plates on top of the six embeds. These embeds are structures designed to level the plates. They ensure that the surface is even and properly aligned for the subsequent operations. The embeds have the flexibility to be adjusted by tightening or loosening certain bolts. This adjustment process is similar to leveling the printing bed of a 3D printer. By carefully adjusting the embeds, SpaceX can ensure that the outer plates are perfectly leveled, which is crucial for the safe and successful launch of rockets. Proper alignment minimizes any imbalances or stress on the launch system during the intense forces experienced during liftoff. In a separate development, SpaceX has successfully received the final load of concrete required for the day's foundation work on the orbital launch mount. The intensive efforts over a marathon-like duration of 15.3 hours resulted in a substantial amount of concrete being delivered. To be precise, a total of 132 truckloads were received on June 25th, followed by an even greater number of 171 truckloads on July 3rd. The cumulative volume of the concrete poured amounts to 2,302 cubic meters, or 3,030 cubic yards, with an estimated weight of 5,411 tons. This weight is comparable to that of a fully loaded Starship, which weighs approximately 5,000 tons. It's worth mentioning that although four additional trucks arrived at the site, they were promptly turned away without unloading their cargo. This indicates the stringent adherence to quality control and safety protocols. On the other hand, SpaceX finds itself embroiled in a legal battle as it faces allegations that its Starship rocket poses a threat to the wildlife habitat in Boca Chica, Texas. The company is now seeking to dismiss the lawsuit that could potentially delay the eagerly anticipated launch of its mega rocket. Responding to a lawsuit filed against the Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA, SpaceX filed a court document denying each and every allegation made by the Texas-based environmental groups behind the lawsuit. In its filing, SpaceX argued that these groups lacked the legal grounds necessary to support their claims. However, the company did acknowledge certain aspects, stating that the Starship's Super Heavy rocket is indeed a powerful vehicle, utilizing liquid methane for propulsion. It further admitted that launching rockets inevitably results in heat, noise, and light. Additionally, SpaceX acknowledged that the concrete launch pad deck had suffered damage during liftoff, resulting in the dispersal of some debris and dust. The FAA is currently assessing the data related to this specific launch. We all know that the IFT-1 launch itself sent a significant cloud of dust and debris toward the surrounding area, raising concerns about the impact on the wildlife habitat that encompasses SpaceX's Boca Chica launch site. Even before the Starship took flight, previous activities at the launch site had already caused a notable decline in shorebird populations and other negative effects on the local ecosystem. However, the FAA has placed a temporary hold on Starship launches pending an ongoing investigation stemming from the inaugural flight. In its court filings, SpaceX emphasized that the environmental assessment has not been altered or withdrawn. The company stated that it remains committed to working towards another Starship launch, indicating its ongoing efforts to address the concerns raised while seeking the necessary approvals from the FAA. As the legal proceedings unfold, the fate of SpaceX's Starship rocket and its impact on the Boca Chica wildlife habitat hang in the balance, with both sides arguing for their respective positions. And that's all for now. If you enjoyed today's video, hit the like button to motivate us. Are you also counting on the SpaceX flight test too, like us? If so, what do you think about their recent preparation? Let us know your thoughts and opinions about Starship and SpaceX in the comment section below. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit that notification bell so you don't miss a thing. Thanks for joining us on this journey.